can't shut the world out. Oh, yeah. Man, look at this guy. Jack and Jack on their second tour through the Adam Bomb Show. What's up, guys?
How you doing, man? It's been a minute.
Can I remember last time Jack J was in, he had the 1996 Olympic jacket on.
Yeah.
Oh, you wore that here.
It was that throwback.
That is a relic, man.
Yep. Got it.
Do you guys get a chance to go shopping and things like that? Like, so busy. Yeah.
Of course. Yeah, I mean, when we have an off day or something, you know, we always find time. But I don't know. That specifically came from a place called the flea market, the Melrose flea market. It's on Fairfax and Melrose out in LA, and it's like all like one of one pieces that you're not gonna find anywhere else. You know, I don't know. A lot of people just be rocking designer stuff, but like everybody rocks that. You feel me?
Do you guys notice as artists what other artists are wearing? Like just the typical stuff. Because I always wondered that. Because I kind of keep track of what other artists and what other radio people are wearing, just because I like the throwback stuff.
Totally.
What I'm wearing. But do you guys take notice of that stuff, what other artists are wearing?
Yeah, I mean, we're like big like hip hop fans, and I feel like we really like we keep up with our favorite rappers, like their styles, you know, like
when I would say like in the mainstream, it's kind of hard to miss, you know, if you're watching an award show, you just take notice of what anybody's wearing.
Totally, totally.
But, yeah, definitely. I would just say I like to keep up with style, but keep it as different as possible at the same time.
Can I tell you, there's this throwback shop, since we're talking about throwback hip hop stuff, in New York City.
Really?
And it's called Mr. Throwback. Oh, and man. I got to show you when we get off the mic, man. You guys would love it. It's all throwback.
Like five.
I'm definitely, I know the guy up there. He's amazing, man. Jack and Jack on the Adam Bomb Show. Let's talk music, man. It's been 2 years since you guys were here. About two years. First of all, let's just do like, how have your musical taste changed in terms of what you're putting out there? What you've heard since then? How your style has been? Have you noticed that when you listen to old Jack and Jack stuff now?
Yeah,
man, totally. I mean,
even just like, I can tell, like 3 weeks ago before we were on tour, we were like trying to really, you know, work out, get fit, eat right. And our gym was like 30 minutes away from our house. So every morning we would put on music, you know, we would listen to like a full project on the way to workout. We had that
like
time.
Like unreleased music, stuff and, that isn't out yet.
Yeah. But this one specific day, we were listening to all of our old stuff. Like, you know, like if you're a Day One fan, you know, like Distance and like Paradise and Flights. Like really old stuff where our delivery is just obvious that we're like 16 years old and we have never done this before. We've never been in a studio. And it's crazy because you don't realize the progression that you're making while you're making it. You know, every day it's so gradual. But then you look back 3 or 4 years later and it's like...
And you can just hear it through the music. You know, if you just play the catalog from start to finish of Jack and I's, you know, it's just such an obvious progression. And Jack and I really, like, the biggest thing is now we're making music just, like, for us, you know what I'm saying? And music that we love, and I think that translates so much more, even with the fans, you know, even with everybody else listening. I think if you really are passionate about it, it translates on stage, it translates when you're talking about
100%.
It, and you can just kind of, I guess, feel that passion more, I think, with this new music.
Will that unreleased stuff ever get released?
Absolutely.
Of course.
Yeah.
Really?
Yes.
We were trying to get this project out before the tour started so we could play all the new songs on the road. But we got this song called Beg that we just put out that like we're going to radio with, so we want to give it some time to breathe and like, you know, we don't want to distract from that first
from
push.
Beg.
You know?
Yes. Yeah, right.
Yes, but so, we do actually have like, we have a whole project put together and we honestly will probably, I mean, just because we're so eager and we kind of, at the end of the day, have control of what we want to do. So we'll probably put it out in December or November.
Just sometime while we're on the road, probably. Honestly.
Jack and Jack's on the Adam Bomb Show. You guys talking about all you have going on, do you ever sit back and go, wow, this is overwhelming? But in a good way, you know what I mean? Like, we got a lot going on.
Honestly, I hope I get to that point where I'm like overwhelmed like that. I feel like I'm still in grind mode, and I feel like I'm nowhere near where I want to be yet, you know? And I think Jack and I have so much more to go, and I feel like our ceiling is so high. And to me, like, every day when I'm working, I don't even feel like I'm working. I don't get stressed out because of it, because I love it. I love being in the studio. I love performing for, you know, all our beautiful fans.
Yeah.
We literally look over to each other, and we're like, dude, like, this is, like, we're getting paid for this. Like, how does this work, man? This is such a dream. So, honestly, it hasn't gotten to that point where we're like, dude, this is too much. So, we're just grateful to be where we are.
Are you talking about your fans? We got some here in studio on the Adam Bomb Show with Jack and Jack.
Yeah.
Can you put into words the feeling when they go absolutely nuts when you first come out on stage? I mean, before you get going.
Yo, it's unbelievable, okay? Because, like, even last night, the last two shows, actually, in Orlando and in Fort Lauderdale, like, I come out and I have to, like, hear this click because, like, I have to start my piano at the right time. And like,
yeah, he like, the show depends on this. He's starting like,
I can't even tell if I'm hitting my cue because like the crowd is literally drowning out like through our in-ears, which are supposed to, keep in mind, keep all the noise out. So,
right.
Like, it's literally they overpower these devices that are meant to, like, completely drown out the crowd. And it's just crazy. Our fans show so much love. They have so much passion. And I would put them up against any other fan base.
Okay, here's kind of a geek question, though. When all that craziness happens, do you ever lose your place sometimes of what you're doing just because in the moment there's so much craziness going on in the crowd?
I would say, like, that's kind of the beauty of each show. It makes every show different because sometimes different crowds will react to different parts in the show differently. And if, like, a certain part ends up being, like, you know, a part that they all love, that just, like, it's like an improv moment where you're like, okay, I gotta run with this. They're giving me all this energy. I gotta give them something back. And it's interesting, and I think that's what makes every show, like, special, is because it's different, because the fans that are there make it a different experience for us, because we do the same thing every night.
Yeah.
But it's
but
like,
it always switches, like, you
it's
know,
never the same group
the
of girls. Yeah. So that's what makes it interesting.
Do you ever remember faces? I know you go so many places.
Yeah, of
you
course.
Play so many. But there are a lot of repeat fans that follow your tour around.
Totally.
Do you kind of remember that kind of stuff? Because it's hard for me to remember, like, you know, when you're constantly going, but you guys have way another level of that.
Yeah, I mean, names are one thing. Names are tough just because you meet so many girls on the
road. Yeah, that's like, it's even hard when
faces,
you know someone.
Without a doubt. I mean, like, even if we're talking about, like, some of our, I guess, the markets we go to a bunch, like New York, LA, like, where we live. Like, there's definitely fans that, like, I just know by name. Like,
yeah, you just know.
I can't even
it's
count
like
them on my fingers.
It's like
they're
homies at
this
point. You just know.
Right.
Because we see them so much. They're always at the airport waiting for us.
But it's crazy because you come back to places like even Atlanta, even though it's a huge city, we're not here that often. And then I come back and I see these fans, like, maybe waiting outside the bus this morning or wherever they might be. And I actually do recognize them, even though I can't prove it. I can't be like, I know that you're Katie. But it's like, I know you. Like, I've looked into your eyes before. So I think that's crazy when we go back to, like, you know, like, Des Moines, Iowa, or, like, you know, just places that we never are.
Yeah,
man.
And whenever we're doing meet and greets, I'm always like, we try to guess if we met them before or not, by, like, looking at their faces.
He's good.
Usually we get it right.
Yeah,
I was killing it yesterday.
See, that's the kind of memory, man, you could really, like, do a side project on, you know, like having that photographic memory.
Hey,
Jack and Jack's on the Adam Bomb Show. I don't want to single one city out, but who has the craziest fans so far that you can remember?
Are you talking, like, internationally, anywhere?
Let's just stay in the U.S.
The U.S.
Yeah, let's just stay in the U.S.
Okay.
The U.S. Is there one show in particular in one city you were like, whoa, man?
I'm trying to think. Okay, I would say, like, Chicago, maybe?
Chicago.
But, see, I don't want any other cities.
Yeah.
You know,
right, yeah.
Bad.
Of course, every city, right?
But
it doesn't matter.
It was just because the Chicago show, like, the capacity was a little bigger. And I'm thinking about, like, the Rosemont one and, like, the Bloomington that weekend. Like,
or, like, the Vic Theater. That
Vic
one
yeah.
I mean, dude, we've had... We've
and
been
that was
blessed,
because,
you know?
Okay, like, in Chicago, that was the one market that, like, we had this track called Like That. That
uh-huh.
was... And, like, we didn't push it to radio or anything, but for some reason in Chicago, like, one of the major stations there was just spinning it a bunch. So I think, like, just more people knew about us in Chicago for some reason, and it was just a little hyper. But, I mean, every city we go to is just always crazy, you know? It's
hard to
compare them to 100%. Each other.
I know, and you're getting paid for this? What? That's amazing. What? Jack and Jack on the Adam Bomb Show. So Gone came out in May. Was it everything when it was done that you were like, yeah, this is exactly how we wanted to sound?
Yeah. No, exactly. I mean, the thing is, it's more... For this project, for me, it was more about not just the way it sounded, but the way that it told the story. Because if you don't know, like, this project was meant to tell, like it was a concept, you know? The whole thing from front to back told the roller coaster ride of a relationship. And, like, the sad truth of a relationship is that most of them end. And the best thing for me was that we put together this long-form video, and we had this director named Emil Nava, and he did a great job of just, like, really telling the story through the music visually, but through his visuals. He, like, made it match perfectly. And
I truly, like, cannot be happier with how it turned out. And I feel like the concept was so there, and, like, we're kind of in this dying age of conceptual projects, you know? It's all, like, a single-driven industry. So
singles.
Jack and I just wanted to put something out there with a little more artistic merit, you know, and something with, like, some substance and value that you can listen to, like, front to back and really, like, feel something, you know? And so I think the Gone project turned out exactly how we envisioned it, even though it didn't even start. Like, we just had a bunch of random tracks.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't have them, like, linking together at first. But then we realized, like, three of them, the three middle tracks, kind of told this journey. And then we're like, yo, let's put, the very first track, Distraction,
first
in there.
First and last.
And the last track in there. So the song about, you know, the beginning, Butterflies, and then the one about heartbreak, like, real heartbreak. And those kind of, like, rounded out the whole project.
So it's like a whole story you're telling, basically.
Yeah, if you watch that whole full-length video, it's like an obvious story, and you watch all five back-to-back-to-back.
And the girls,
like,
the love interests are the same in all of them, and it's like the whole thing is a story. Yeah.
Man, what a cool feeling to see that end, like, the whole thing to come together.
Yeah, it was amazing.
Jack and Jack's on the Adam Bomb Show, so let's take it right here, man. Halloween, you don't see this on the radio, but in the
video.
Okay, so do you remember the first time you went trick-or-treating?
Yeah.
The
actually,
very first time. Okay, he's like, yeah.
Because you have such a great memory at all this.
I'm sure my parents brought me when I was like two.
No, yeah. Okay, all right.
I kind of remember that, though. I was dressed up as my dad was the Penguin villain from Batman.
Oh,
okay. I was like a little Batman. I was like a baby Robin. And my brother was Batman, actually. And I was the baby Robin. Baby I don't Robin. Know why I was Robin. What? That's,
like, hey, you're the side.
How do you remember this stuff? This is amazing.
Honestly, only because I've seen a picture of it. I don't
know. Dude, I was like instantly when you say Halloween. My first Halloween that I remember, I think, was second grade. Mrs. Kyle and Mrs. Rice's class.
Miss West was better.
Yeah, he had West. We were separated that year.
Yeah.
Kyle and Rice was better.
It was
better.
Our first year of separation, actually.
But anyways, I was that Sully from Monsters, Inc.
I had
the coolest, like...
You were stunting, bro.
It was so
man,
cool.
You got
yeah.
a picture of that? Put that one
I
out,
actually
right?
do. No, I actually will. I'll send you one.
I was jealous. A lot of kids were jealous of you.
I know. I mean, like, Owen Harry was the only kid who had the idea to dress up like him, too. But, yeah, I don't know.
That's if you want to relive that, by the way, there's candy in that bucket. So if you just want to relive your... Oh, come on, man. We always put candy in there. Yeah, I know. You got to put that away.
Oh, goodness.
It's tour season. Right?
Jack and You're Jack right. on that tour season right now. They're playing Buckhead Theater tonight, man. Going to be jam-packed. And these guys behind me are going to be there, too. Thanks for coming into the Adam Bomb Show, guys.
Thank what an amazing...
I always love the time you take for fans. And there's, and you guys are, like, one of the great examples where you don't... turn down anything. You just do it all. And I think that's great for fans, man.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. I mean, you got to realize, like, as an artist, you would not be presented with any of these opportunities if it weren't for the ones who were there for you, supporting you from the from the jump, you know
right.
what I'm
saying? Especially for us, you know, just, like, being, starting as, like, completely unsigned artists and really amassing that huge fan base before we signed to a label, you know? Like, it's all because of them. That's why we have what we have. So we definitely got to give back always whenever they ask for anything. It's theirs, you know?
Y'all are great coming through. Jack and Jack on the Adam Bomb Show. What do you think, ladies? They're on their phones. They're like, wait, what?